I am Dr. W.P. Gulnore from Kamlani Mahavidyalaya Nagpur. Today we are going to discuss the Bayer strength theory of cycloalkanes and or cyclohexane. And as we know, chemical properties of cycloalkanes shows that lower members of cycloalkanes are unstable. They are comparatively unstable. And in this case, the ring opening can take place very easily when it reacts with the hydrogen or halogen and giving the addition product. On the other side, higher members are comparatively stable and they give the substitution product, and the relative stability of increases from cyclopropane to cyclohexane. This increase of stability or relative stability with the increase of ring size is explained by Bayer's, that is the name of the scientist is the Adolf Bayer, and therefore this theory is known as Bayer's strength theory. So increase of relative stability from cyclopropane to cyclohexane is explained by the Adolf Bayer, and this theory is known as the Bayer's strength theory. So this is the theory explained by Bayer to explain the relative stability of cycloalkane and particularly from cyclopropane to cyclohexane. So what are the limitations of Bayer strength theory? What are the important postulate of Bayer strength theory that we are going to discuss in today's part? So the topic is cycloalkane, and in this cycloalkane we are discussing, this is the part number 8, and in part number 8 we are discussing today what is the Bayer strength theory, important postulate of Bayer strength theory, and the relative stability of cycloalkanes, that is from cyclopropane to cyclohexane. And as we know, what is Bayer strength theory? As we know from chemical properties of the cycloalkane, it shows that lower members are unstable, and in this case ring opening can take place easily and give the addition product, but in case of higher members are quite stable, and substitution, and they give the substitution product, and with the retention of the ring, therefore we can say that relative stability of the from cyclopropane to cyclohexane increases. This increase in the stability with the increase of the ring size is explained by Adolf Bayer, and this theory is known as the Bayer strength theory. And in 1885, Adolf Bayer proposed the theory for explaining the relative stability of the first few cycloalkanes, and this theory based on the theory that normal angle between any pair of bond of the carbon atom is a 109°28". So what are the important points of the Bayer strength theory that we are going to see first? So in this case, these are the important postulate of Bayer strength theory. So 5 points are there of the Bayer strength theory, and this Bayer strength theory explain the relative stability of first few cycloalkanes. So we can say that from cyclopropane to cyclohexane. So what are the important postulate? Based on this postulate, we can explain the stability, relative stability of the cycloalkane. So important points of the Bayer strength theory is there. Number one point, a carbon atom is bonded to 4 other atoms, is a tetrahedron in shape, and therefore the angle between any pair of adjacent bond is a tetrahedron. And as we know, what is tetrahedral angle? 109°28". Second point is, all the carbon atom present in the cycloalkane molecule lie in a one plane. So all the carbon atoms are lie in a one plane. As a result of this, bond angle between any two adjacent carbon atoms are no longer equal to the normal tetrahedral angle of the 109.28", but they are either less or more than this angle. So generally, what is now here, all the carbon atoms in the molecule of cycloalkane, they lie in a one plane, therefore the bond between the two atoms is not equal, but this bond angle may be less or more, therefore there is some angle strain. So which is explaining number 3 point, any deviation or distortion from the normal tetrahedral angle in imparts strain, and this we can say that it gives the instability to the resultant molecule. This strength is known as the angle strength. So any deviation from the tetrahedral angle to the other less or more can be explained, and this is the strength known as the angle strength. इसको बोलते हैं एंगल स्ट्रेंथ. और चौथा पॉइंट है द ग्रेटर द डेविएशन, जितना ज्यादा डेविएशन होगा, ग्रेटर द डेविएशन फ्रॉम द नॉर्मल टेट्राहेड्रल एंगल, ग्रेटर इज द एंगल स्ट्रेंथ. ग्रेटर द डेविएशन, ग्रेटर द एंगल स्ट्रेंथ, एंड हेंस ग्रेटर इज द इंस्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द रिजल्टेंट मॉलिक्यूल. सो ये चौथा पॉइंट इंपॉर्टेंट है. ग्रेटर द डेविएशन फ्रॉम द टेट्राहेड्रल एंगल, ग्रेटर इज द एंगल स्ट्रेंथ, एंड हेंस ग्रेटर इज द इंस्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल. And number 5, the greater the stability of the ring system, more easily it is formed. जितना stability ज़्यादा होगा ring system का, it is easily formed. So these are the 5 important postulate of the bare strength theory. So first point is, when the carbon atom bonded to other 4 atoms, then it is a tetrahedral, and therefore the bond angle in tetrahedral is a 109°20'. Second point is that there is a when there is any all the carbon atoms lie in one plane, and therefore the angle may be either less or more as compared to the tetrahedral angle. Third point is that there is a deviation or distortion between the angle of the molecule, and this deviation is known as the angle strain. And number 4, greater the deviation, greater the angle strain, and greater is the instability of the molecule. And greater stability ring of ring system, more easily it is formed. So based on all the points suggested by the Bayer, we can explain the relative stability of the cycloalkane molecules. So now, in case of cyclopropane, Bayer strength theory explain how there is a deviation. In case of cyclopropane, 3 carbon atoms occupy the corners of the equilateral triangle, and therefore cyclopropane has carbon-carbon-carbon bond angle is 60°. This shows that normal tetrahedral angle is 109°28' between the any two bonds, and it is compressed to 60°. Now the two bonds involved in the in case of this, it is pulled, so it is calculated. So compression to 60°, it compressed from tetrahedral angle, and each of the two bond involved is pulled in by. तो ये निकाल सकते हैं अपन स्ट्रेंथ 1/2 अपॉन इनटू 109 टेट्राहेड्रल एंगल माइनस बॉन्ड एंगल इन दी इन दिस केस साइक्लोप्रोपेन. सो इट डिफरेंस इज कमिंग आउट 24°44'. दिस वैल्यू 24.44' रिप्रेजेंट द एंगल स्ट्रेंथ. सो दिस इज द एंगल स्ट्रेंथ और द डेविएशन थ्रू व्हिच द ईच बॉन्ड फ्रॉम द नॉर्मल टेट्राहेड्रल डायरेक्शन. सो दिस इज शोन हियर इन द फिगर. ये है CH2, and this is the angle CH2 cyclopropane. ये cyclopropane में ये है 60°. एक्चुअली एंगल इज tetrahedral एंगल ये है 109°20'. तो ये दोनों का डिफरेंस आता है 24°44'. तो ये एंगल स्ट्रेंथ इन दिस वे. इन केस ऑफ साइक्लोब्यूटेन आल्सो शोन दिस इज द 109°20', एंड दिस इज द 90° इन केस ऑफ साइक्लोब्यूटेन. तो एंगल स्ट्रेंथ स्लाइटली it is less, but it is in case of cyclopropane it is more. So in this way we can calculate, and this is the formula to calculate the value angle strain. This is the angle strain in cyclopropane, this is the angle strain in cyclobutane. So angle strain can be calculated in other cases also. So this diagram shows clearly how to calculate the angle strain. So this is the figure we showed in this case, and this angle strain determine the stability of the ring. As we know that Bayer shows that any deviation of the bond angle from the normal tetrahedral value imposes that the condition of internal strain on the ring. He also shows that all the cycloalkane were planar, and thus and therefore they calculated the angle through which each of the valency bond was deflected from normal direction, and therefore this angle strain is a which determine the stability of the ring. So this is the angle strain which determine the stability of the ring. In case of cyclopropane, we have seen angle strain is 24°44', and this strain, angle strain or deviation through which each bond of the normal tetrahedral direction is shown in the figure. And angle strain is maximum in case of cyclopropane. According to the Bayer strength theory, cyclopropane should be highly strained molecule, and therefore it is a most unstable. Cyclopropane ring should therefore be expected open up on slightest provocation and the releasing the strain within it. So this is the figure how to calculate this angle strain is shown in this case, and in case of cyclobutane also we can calculate the angle strain, and it is a in case of angle strain in cyclobutane can be calculated 1/2 1:28 - 90. So it is coming angle strain is 9° 44' as shown in the second figure B. Following this procedure we can calculate the angle strain in other cycloalkane, and different the angle strain is shown in the table. So here is the table which shows different angle strain in the cycloalkanes. So angle strain for other cycloalkane can be calculated in the similar manner that we have seen in case of cyclopropane, in case of cyclobutane. So in this table shows the angle strain, heat of combustion per CH2 group, and here cyclopropane angle in bond angle is 16. This is the formula to calculate. So this is the deviation in is more in case of cyclobutane plus 9°. In case of cyclopentane this is very less, and again it is minus, this is minus, this is minus. So as we go from cyclopropane to cyclooctane, angle strain it shows the increase, and so this is the increase, and bond angle also shown here, and deviation is shown. So from cyclopropane to cyclohexane it is increases, and heat of combustion also shown. This is the value, it is decreases. See now here, decrease from cyclopropane to cyclohexane. So how to find angle strain and what is the bond angle is different cycloalkane, and its geometry is shown. Geometry is there in case cyclopropane equilateral triangle, in case of cyclobutane square planar, in case of cyclopentane geometry is regular or pentagon, regular pentagon, cyclohexane regular hexagon. So this table shows the complete data, and as we know positive value of the angle strain indicate that bond angles are compressed, while negative value means expansion of the bond angle from the tetrahedral angle. In these cases the molecule will be strained. Strain is there. In other words, we can say that it is the magnitude of angle strain and not its sign which determine the strain, and hence instability of the molecule is there. So again remember that it is the magnitude of angle strain, not its sign, which determine the strain, and hence instability of the molecule is there. From this table it shows that angle strain rapidly decreases in going from cyclopropane to cyclopentane, and then increases slowly. Hence we can say that most reactive of all the cycloalkanes, while cyclobutane with less angle strain should be little more stable, hence less reactive than cyclopropane. Cyclopentane with at least least amount of angle strain should be more stable in all these cycloalkanes. All these shown also it is also supported by some experimental fact, and on the basis of this now so here angle strain in case of cyclobutane already we have seen. So the angle strain in the case of cyclobutane is less than that in case of cyclopropane, and signify the greater stability. As expected, cyclobutane undergo ring opening reaction, but only under special conditions. The angle strain is minimum in the case of cyclopentane. This shows that cyclopentane is under least strain and should be more stable. It is not surprising that cyclopentane does not undergo ring opening reaction. The angle strain in case of cyclohexane is higher, and angle strain in case of cyclopentane we have seen, and angle strain in case of cyclohexane now is higher as compared to the cyclopentane. This strain increases continuously with the increase in the ring. According to the bare strain theory, cyclohexane and higher cycloalkanes should become increasingly unstable and hence more reactive. Contrary, we can say that to this prediction, cyclohexane and the higher members are found to be quite stable. they do not undergo ring opening reaction. Instead, they resemble open chain alkanes in reactivity. That is, they react by substitution. The Bayer strain theory satisfactorily account for the exceptional reactivity of cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclopentane, but it is not valid for cyclohexane. So Bayer strain theory account for the reactivity of cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclopentane, but not valid for cyclohexane and higher members. And so here is a shown in case of cyclohexane. So now this Bayer strain theory satisfactorily account for this case and not for the cyclohexane. Now there are some evidences in case of the Bayer strain theory. Two evidences are there, and these two evidences to support the Bayer strain theory. So we can say that according to Bayer strain theory, there is a in case of cyclopropane, it is unstable and therefore highly reactive, and then because more deviation, so angle strain increases from cyclopropane to cyclohexane, and cyclopentane have less angle strain, therefore it is a stable as compared to also cyclohexane. And as we have seen, cyclohexane is a having more angle strain, and therefore it is also it is a stable. So relative stability increases as the ring size increases from cyclopropane to cyclohexane. So this relative stability is explained by Bayer on the basis of his theory known as the Bayer strain theory. And there are two evidences in support of Bayer strain theory. Number one is reactivity of double bond. As we know, double bond may be regarded as a two-membered ring, and with a carbon-carbon bond angle is 0 degree. Therefore, angle strain in this case is the is shown 109 degree 28 minutes minus 20 here 8, and it is coming 54.44. This angle strain is highest of all the cycloalkanes. Hence, the alkene should be highly reactive, which is in agreement with the observed fact. So, in case of this shows the reactivity of the double bond in case of alkene. So, this also support that they are highly reactive. Carbon-carbon double bond present in the compound or molecule are highly reactive, which is agreement with the observed fact. So, this is another point to support the reactivity of alkenes or double bond containing compound. Second point is reactivity of cyclopropane and cyclobutane. A comparison of the heats of combustion. So heat of combustion is also very important of the cycloalkane, which shows that cyclopropane and cyclobutane have more energy per CH2 group as compared to corresponding straight chain alkene. Consequently, they should be less stable than the corresponding ion alkanes, and it is therefore reasonable to believe that their tendency to undergo addition reaction through the ring fission is related to this instability. So, as we know, in case of cyclopropane, cyclobutane, ring opening can take place because they are highly reactive, and this point of reactivity of cyclopropane, cyclobutane is also support the Bayer strain theory. So, these are the two points to support the Bayer strain theory. So, Bayer strain theory explains the relative stability of the different cycloalkanes from cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclopentane, and cyclohexane. And last is the limitations of Bayer strain theory. And two limitations are there to this Bayer strain theory. And important limitations are, number one, on the basis of Bayer strain theory, we can say that carbon-carbon bond should be difficult to form. On the basis of Bayer strain theory, carbon-carbon bond formation should be difficult, and it is highly reactive and hence highly unstable. So it is difficult to form the carbon-carbon bond on the basis of Bayer strain theory, because in case of cyclopropane there is a strain, and formation of carbon-carbon bond is difficult to form because it is highly reactive and hence it is highly unstable, and this is the limitation. So in contrast, it is known fact that carbon-carbon double bond is easily formed by dehydrogenation of alkylamide or dehydration of alcohol, but as compared to that formation of carbon-carbon bond, so formation of double bond is very can form easily because of the dehydrogenation of alkylamide or dehydration of alcohol. So this is the stable. So this is okay, but now formation of carbon-carbon bond is difficult. So this is one of the limitation. And the second limitation is that on the basis of bare strength theory, cyclohexane and a ring having 7 or more carbon atom should be less stable. As we know, stability increases and cyclohexane and higher members are stable, and their stability containing the cyclohexane in case of cyclohexane and higher members should be less stable than cyclopentane as compared to cyclopentane in comparison to the cyclopentane. But heat of combustion of data shows that heat of combustion shown in the table, and this data, heat of combustion data shows that cyclopentane, cyclohexane and ring containing 7 and more carbon atoms are equally stable. So this is another limitation. So what is now, according to the bare strength theory, it is okay. The increase the size of ring increases the stability, so they are stable, higher members are stable. But according to bare strength theory, cyclopentane is less stable, and there is a very less angle strength, and cyclohexane is more stable as compared to cyclopentane. But now this heat of combustion data shows that cyclopentane, cyclohexane and higher members containing higher carbon atoms, more carbon atoms are equally stable. So these data show because there is an increase but not much more. So these are the two limitations of bare strength theory. So here today we have seen what is the bare strength theory. So there is an angle strength, there is a deviation or distortion in the angle strength in case of cyclopropane is a more deviation as compared to cyclobutane have less deviation, in case of cyclopentane having the least deviation, and therefore this relative deviation or relative distortion in the angle strength is on the basis of that that is the Bayer is a scientist who explained the relative stability of the some cycloalkanes from cyclopropane to cyclohexane. So what is cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclopentane, cyclohexane? So cyclohexane is a more stable, and different limitations also we have seen. So this is the important theory given by Adolf Bayer to explain the relative stability of cycloalkanes from cyclopropane to cyclohexane. So which one is more stable, stability increases, and how they take place the reaction, and chemical reactions also show some effect on this stability. So ring opening take place in case of cyclopropane and cyclobutane, but difficult to open the ring in case of cyclopentane and cyclohexane. And now in case of cyclopentane there is a very less angle strength, and therefore it is a stable as compared to that. But cyclohexane is more stable because again there is a more angle strength. So depending upon the angle strength we can determine the relative stability of the cyclohexane.